Let me tell you about the factory. First, I want to talk to you about Nova. That's where I work. I'm a consultant there. And Nova's about creating tech startups. And we look for founders with domain expertise. So someone like you in fluid mechanics, you have a domain expertise, but maybe you don't maybe have the tech expertise, but commercial expertise to take a startup and scale it up, or maybe you do. But we're looking for people who have domain expertise, and we co-found startups with them. But we look for problems, and we start off with a problem, and then we figure out the solution after that. We have office in Liverpool and Manchester. I come from Manchester. We have an office in Islamabad where a lot of our dev is done. We've invested in 80 businesses so far. 40 of them are active, about 2 exits, and we're looking to invest around 6 million by next year. So these are some of our companies, and they range from helping people to detect early signs of dementia, fintech, edtech. We've got one in sort of consumer technology, an Uber for tech services, one for allergies, one about skipping queues at a bar. I mean, it's literally every problem that you can imagine, we'll try and find a solution for it across edtech, healthcare, fintech, software and hardware. So that's a little bit about what we do. So, customer factory overview. What is a customer factory? So we're basically taking an unaware customer, you take them through this cycle, which I might talk to, and you make them to a happy customer. Now, sorry if some of this is a bit noddy and a bit obvious, if it is, stop me. But I'm going to talk to you about the mechanics of a customer journey. And how you measure that is through what's called pirate metrics, and it's about acquisitions. That's the first time someone is acquired, to how you activate them. So what's the first point that you provide value to someone, monetizable value? All right, if you're in Silicon Valley, you don't care about monetizable value, you just care about value, and figure out monetization a bit later. But for most UK startups, you acquire a customer, you figure out what monetizable value you can give them, you then monetize that value by taking revenue, and then you figure out how do you retain that customer, and how do you enable that customer to be referred. And actually, interestingly, when you get through your product, most people think, all right, actually, you know what, I'll ask, what do you think is the most important metric here?
Referrals.
Acquisition.
Referrals.
Retention. Well, good. Yes, retention. You did say it first, and you changed your mind.
I thought, this guy
works at Nova, so he's cheating.
Right.
So yeah, retention is seen as the most important when you're trying to achieve something called product market fit. Again, this all follows, I was just saying before, guys, that this follows the lean methodology. So lean methodology is around not going sort of gung-ho on a product and raising 10 million quid and launching something and then realise that no one wants it. And it goes hand-in-hand with trying to measure these at every step of the way. But yeah, when you have a product out in the market, retention is one of the key items. But it really all depends what product you have, but most people say retention is the most important one. I'm going to talk you through this in about 5-10 minutes, and then I want you guys to start working in, I'll split it into two groups, and then we're going to try and figure out some problems together. So, acquisition, how do you identify your early adopters, and how do you attract them into your business? And this is typically through either paid advertising, through marketing efforts. So you could have 2 million impressions on an advert, and let's say 100,000 come onto your landing page. You've acquired that person. What's the first point? You put them into your factory. You then start activating them, so you provide them with an experience that gives them value that you're hoping that they will pay for. They then start paying for that through your pricing model. So you bring them into your product or service, you give them some value, and you put a price that value through your business model, whether it's a subscription or a one-off payment. That could be they see an advert and the advertiser pays you. There's a number of business models that you can deploy, but essentially this is where you start taking revenue and you have your sale and now you're happy, but it didn't actually stop there. You didn't have to retain them. And like I said, the most important metric is retention, but it's very industry specific. So Facebook will measure retention daily. How many people are going on multiple times a day? Whereas if you have, I don't know, an edtech product in recruitment, you're not going to measure that daily because people might not come to it daily. So it really depends what your service is. But yeah, different companies will measure it differently. Facebook's a good example, and Instagram, same company, but they'll measure it multiple times a day, how many people are going on, and that's the important metric And then finally, bringing those people, getting those people to bring in more people, i.e. network effect is a referral engine. So how do you refer people, discount codes? Uber did this very well. So rather than giving people money off, they said, if you share this with a friend, they will get money off and you'll get money off. It starts, it gives people incentive to refer people. So this is the entire factory, and each one of these is how you measure the entire journey. So what I want you guys to do is think about the company that you work in, or a startup idea that you have, or a startup that you're working in, and let's go through this journey. Let's go through this entire journey. And if you've got real stats that you can bring up, then bring up. So if you know how many impressions you're getting, or how many people are you're acquiring, or you know what your retention is, then put those numbers in. But what we want to do is something called the Harry Cable. Any Spurs fans? Any Spurs haters? Good, fine. Imagine this is someone else then. But I don't watch football, so I have no idea if it's true or not. But I was told that Harry Kane has this method called the 1%. I mean, it's basically around Japanese manufacturing, but essentially the way he plays football, I've been told by a Spurs fan, that he'll rather improving one part of the game, i.e. shots on goal, he'll improve different parts of it. So if you improve your passing by 1%, and you improve your tackling by 1%, and you improve your shots by 1%, and then shots on target 1%, all those small changes will inevitably, the cumulative effect of all that is a massive improvement. So when we look at this, most people think, all right, let's just think about revenue and business model, and how do we change that to get the most value out of people? But actually, you might only need to change that by a small percent, I don't know, drop the price slightly or increase it slightly. And if you improve that slightly, and improve that slightly, and improve that slightly, and that, and that, all of a sudden, your overall improvement is massive. And it's about changing each part of it by a small amount. So imagine that's the footballer of your dreams, and how they should be playing football is improving it ever so slightly from making, you know, doing better corners and crosses and goalkeeping, and improving each one of those parts of the game by a really, really small amount. So think about how you can improve your conversion through, let's say, a sign-up or on Google Forms. How can you improve the value that you give people? How can you improve that revenue? And how do you improve retention and referrals? I know, I'll give you an example. I'm working at a company, and our value is really good. Our pricing model is bang on, and people are referring and people are retaining, but actually we're getting 10 million people onto the site and only 100 of them are converting. So I'll probably focus here and then focus on improving this and then focus on improving that. So look at your own companies and figure out where in this customer factory is the biggest pain point, and then figure out some experiments to try out. Again, let's keep this lean as well. Let's think of some very cheap or almost free stuff that you can do and improve to change the entire experience of a customer.